To come and write over something else? Are there like rules?
If you can put up something better.
There's rules to bombing.
There's rules to everything.
It goes.
Breaking the rules.
If you, if you see like a bomb or something, like just the right name, you can go over it with throw up. Throw up. It goes over a bomb. Take that kid. What goes over a throw up?
Throw up. Show me a throw up. What?
If we come across one, show me a throw up.
Well, there probably won't be any throw-ups up here, really. Well, actually, I put one throw-up up.
Throw-up is just a bubble letter
tag. It's just a bubble letter tag getting your name up.
Not necessarily that much.
Right. A lot of stuff can come through from it. I mean, a lot of stuff can go over it.
Yeah.
It's not a set piece.
Nobody cares if you go over throw-up?
No.
As long as it's something better.
Yeah, if it's something better. Better writer. But, usually with most writers, there's so many bombs around that one covered up won't really matter too much.
Yeah, but then the only thing that can go over a bomb is a piece.
Right.
And the only thing that can go over a piece is a better piece.
It's a better piece. A bigger piece. Bigger and better usually goes over the top of
it. Bomb. Simple lines. Fill in. Represent.
How long does that take to do?
About 10 minutes.
Not even.
It depends. Depends on where you're hitting up and how long you've got to do it. Sometimes
if you're hitting up a highway or something.
Yeah. Sometimes a bomb is just like the blue line, no fill, because it's so quick to get up. And mainly writers stick with one throw up, because it's easy, it's repetitive, they can get it up in a lot of places, little time.
Are there rules where you can do throw ups?
No.
Not really. Well, I mean, like churches and cemeteries and stuff, you're not supposed to hit up. No one does.
Just out of respect.
Just because, yeah. But no, basically anything is fair game. It's all about making the city look better.
Yep.
You can usually tell a writer by their style because they're always putting up the same kind of writing.
Yeah.
Even if the words are different, it's still done with that style that they write in.
Yeah.
How come you can't read what they're saying?
That's part of the style.
It's all about art.
Yep.
Everyone's got their different style and everyone does it their own way.
Describing what you need to say, how you're going to put it up in your own
abstract sort of way.
What you want? I get the money with the money.
after when they come up here.
Props. Show them their skill.
Explain to my city illiterate friends what props are.
City illiterate?
Representation, all writers recognizing and giving.
That's who they are.
Yeah, props stands for proposition, you know.
Respect.
It's all about respect.
It's all about letting everyone know who you are. Getting down. And Syracuse's name's Kit Ford. He's been writing for about 10 years. He's got the most respect out of any writer besides Sean at Syracuse. In case you're wondering about size on this one, I'm 6 foot. That's how big this is.
How do writers get their paint?
Any way they want. A lot of kids rack. Stealing. Go into a store, load up your pants, load up your sleeves, whatever. Paint's too expensive these days.
Is that why you wear big pants?
Yeah, right.
Say that. Yeah, paint probably goes about $3.50 a can. That it gets kind of pricey when you're thinking about dozens of cans of paint for a piece.
Get down.
Like, what are laws in Syracuse like?
Well, if you're caught with graffiti equipment, it's a Class B misdemeanor.
B misdemeanor.
And if you're caught in the act of, it's a Class A misdemeanor.
So that means you gotta, like, pay a fine.
Yep.
He's like, oh, sorry.
Basically.
So, have you ever gotten caught?
No.
Either of you?
No.
Have people you know gotten caught?
No. But
nah, police in Syracuse are corrupt.
Yeah. I heard a story about Wise. He spent a couple of days in jail for painting.
So what happens, when can they convict you? Can they get you if they find paint in your bag?
Yeah.
Yep.
But that's only like a $50 fine.
Right.
What happens if they find your sketches?
Then you're screwed.
Actually, nothing. Unless you're painting.
Unless you got paint, there's like reasonable evidence. Yeah. Unless it's like up somewhere.
Right.
So.
Why don't you just do it there, you got it.
So are you guys concerned about getting caught?
No. This makes it fun. You don't gotta worry about that.
You ever play Cowboys and Indians when you were a kid? Running from the law? That's what it is.
You go. I mean, you do look over your shoulders when you're doing shit, but it's all good. With open eyes and an open mind, because if you start looking at shit like it's
graffiti,